Hey, High Levelers. In this video, I want to come here and give you a little bit of an update regarding AI employee in Highlevel. Right now, AI employee has just expanded. Highlevel has now included a new feature called Ask AI inside of the AI employee platform, if that makes sense. And I want to come here and bring a video and tell you some of the features. Currently, it still is in beta, so it's still a little bit buggy, but I at least want to give you what to expect, what kind of things it's going to do, and so forth. So let's hop into it and take a look. Okay, so here is just the help article regarding AI employee. And the reason I show this to you is because I want to sit back and show you the main features here. So if we take a look here, these are the main sort of six features that AI employee came out with as of, I think, October 2024, whenever they had their yearly conference and came out with AI employee. All of these six features were lumped in and included inside of AI employee. And this is all the things that you get with the current specials that Highlevel has going on, running their summer of AI promotions and giving you free 30 days, which if you have not taken advantage of that, you absolutely should. But one of the things I want to show you is the new feature here. Now they haven't updated the help article yet, and I think it's because it's still in beta. But if you take a look at any one of your sub accounts, this is one of my demo accounts. And if you take a look at unlock AI employee for free, you'll see here's what you end up getting. You get all of these features, the same six that you just saw right here, just laid out a little bit differently. But here's the big one. Ask AI, generate personalized content in a conversational chat GPT style. Now, what's their expectations of what plans do they have for this? So I've got some answers for you and some answers I don't, quite frankly, because I wasn't able to get them from support inside of the Highlevel platform. So that's just the way it is. But right now, anytime you've wanted to use AI employee inside of Highlevel, you've always had to go to a particular interface inside of Highlevel. If you want to use content AI, you have to go inside of one of the content tools like the blog writer or the email builder or the social planner, something like that. And inside of those particular tools, you were given an area that you can click on to say generate content, generate text, generate image, but you weren't able to sit back and have a freestyle approach to ChatGPT like you do with just say OpenAI. If you were to go to ChatGPT, click on sort of new project, new search, whatever you want to call it, and then type in a prompt and begin a new conversation with ChatGPT, you couldn't do that inside of Highlevel because Highlevel doesn't have an interface to allow you to do that. So Ask AI is Highlevel's, I believe, first approach to allowing you to have an open interface to ChatGPT directly through Highlevel platform. But one of the things that they're doing is they're making the ChatGPT more intelligent with regards to Ask AI, meaning when you type something in inside of Ask AI, you can have it do things. Now, there are certain limiting things that you can have it do for right now. It can't do all of these things, but this is where I see Ask AI go. I was like, hey, I'll build me a funnel that does this. And then right now, it'll actually sit back and build you a funnel just from doing that, given the instructions that you give it. Right now, it can already go through the process of creating communities. So you just say, hey, Ask AI, create me a community that is for this purpose. So it'll go through, and now ChatGPT is smart enough to know, okay, now you're asking for something inside of Highlevel. In order for me to do that, I'm going to need to know, what is the name of the community? What do you want to have this? What's the name of it? Where do you want to, all these other configuration settings that you would normally go through? Now ChatGPT is smart and intelligent enough to ask you those questions. And once it asks those of you, then it can go through and create the community and do it all for you without you having to do it yourself. So this, the interface that Highlevel is looking to build, sort of an open interface directly with a ChatGPT to allow you to just put in a direct prompt and get information back, or you can sit back and have it do things inside of Highlevel. Now, again, it still is in beta, so I'm going to show you some things that are a little bit buggy, but let me show you where it is first. So if we take a look here at the top right here, I'm going to try to blow this up a little bit. Notice we have these icons. This right here is Ask AI. So just make a note of that little star, these two star configurations. For right now, that is the icon or the symbol that represents Ask AI inside of the Highlevel platform, and I'm going to show you where you will also see that at in different places. So just keep that in mind that whenever you start seeing that symbol, that it's going to be integrated with Ask AI. Let's go ahead and click on this. Now, this is the main screen that you get. Now, let me move myself out of the way here so I can come over here and blow this up a little bit and make this a little bit easier to read. So right now, a couple things about Ask AI. Two main roles have access to Ask AI at this point. Now, this says only visible to agency admins. That is not correct, at least not completely correct. It is only available to agency admins. So any agency admin that you have in any sub account, you will be able to see Ask AI. Now, if you are not an agency admin, and if you're an agency, let's just say an agency or a sub account admin or a sub account user, you will be able to see this if you have the $97 unlimited AI employee feature enabled for that sub account. You will also be able to get access to Ask AI, at least the beta version, okay? So this is just some of the things that Highlevel has out as an example of things that it can able to do. Draft a social media post for my campaign. So right now, again, I know this is something that you can go into the social media planner, generate content, and you can have it do this yourself. But the cool part about it is you don't have to go into the social planner anymore. You know, you could just sit, you know, let's just say you don't want to create a post right now. You just want to have the Ask AI system generate maybe 30 days worth of post content for you. And then you're putting that into some other type of Google Doc or something like that, that you're going to be able to utilize later. So rather than having to go through the social planner for that, now you have this nice just open tool for Ask AI to be able to do that. Some other things, summarizing a contact. I haven't had a chance to sit back and utilize this yet, but my understanding of just looking at the documentation is if you have a contact that has a long list of conversations and so forth, apparently if you summarize the contact, it'll give you a heads up rather than you having to go back and read all the conversations about back and forth and what somebody's looking for. It can summarize it and maybe give you just a heads up real quick. So that can be useful if you have contacts that you've been in communications with a lot. Writing email to promote a new product, again, all driven by content, and then even generate a funnel here. So these are all things that Ask AI is actually built to do already in beta. Now, here's another very important thing that I want to sit back and point out. I've created another video on my channel, and I'll link it to this video. It's called Brand Voice. Now, it may not seem that important right now. Brand Voice is actually an area, a little feature inside of Highlevel that Highlevel wanted to create so that all the content that you're going to create across all the platform, could be social media posts, could be blog, could be funnel copy, it could be anything. It's all written with the same purpose, the same tone, and so forth as any of the other of writing. So that way you don't have a blog article that's written one way and then a text on your website written another, and then emails that are written a different way. So Brand Voice is just a way that it can integrate with the AI system to let AI know what your company is, what purpose it is. And we'll take just a quick look at that, what that is. And the reason I bring it up is because you can integrate Brand Voice directly with Ask AI. Notice here at the bottom. If you can see this, use Brand Voice. Now, I've already created a Brand Voice. This is my DigiGlobal Agency, is my demo account. So right now, I'm going to go ahead and click on, if I edit this, notice I have a couple different options here. I can select multiple Brand Voices if I want to. So if you want to have different voices for different types of writing, you absolutely can. But you can also centralize all of the writing to be the same, similar in tone, so that if you ever want to change it from one tone to another, all you have to do is go to one place in your Brand Voice, change the tone for that one, and then moving forward, all the content that gets created will again use that new tone. So right now, Brand Voice is being integrated into the AI platform. If you're not familiar with it, I'd have to highly recommend that you at least look at it, because, and it's important enough, because right now, Brand Voice is one of the first things that conversation AI asks you to pick out when you want to create a new bot. Now, if you haven't done that yet, I'm just giving you a heads up. I have a whole other video about Brand Voice and specifically conversation AI and some of the changes that Highlevel has made with that particular feature set to include Brand Voice in it. So right now, let me go ahead and just kind of show you. If you take a look here, I believe it's, where is that? Marketing? Yeah, under marketing, if you go to Brand Boards. Now, Brand Boards are nothing new. This is something that's been out for over a year. You know, being able to put in your own brands, your own colors, your own fonts, and things like that. Now you get this new thing here called Brand Voice, and they're integrating all these things together. So right now, if we take a look, this is what happens or what is included in the Brand Voice setup here. So I'm going to take a look here. There are a few things here that you can put in that are optional, other ones that are required. So just please pay attention to that. I'm going to blow this up a little bit. You have to put in a brand name, and this is the brand name that you're trying to public. Could be your company name, could it be a doing business as name, but I've just filled out all the information, the type of business, the website, an email address, and all of this information, again, is to be used by the AI platform to generate information. So if you do create a prompt later and you're using a Brand Voice, you're saying, AI, you tell AI, hey, include all of my company contact information. Now you don't need to put that in there because you have it all already inside of Brand Voice. AI knows that information and can now just pull it directly from Brand Voice and create that automatically. So here's the tone part right here, what I was talking about here. So if you want to be professional, friendly, all you have to do is come change it here. And then moving forward, the tone changes for all of your writing. So some of the other things it wanted you to do is create this brand identity. So your target audience, you're letting AI know what it is that you're trying to target. Who are you trying to write content for so they can make sure it can write content for the right people? And I put in here, business owners who need help answering calls, replying to reviews and booking clients automatically. Just trying to look at selling the AI system. Customer pain points. Again, these are pain points that your customer may have. Owner missed calls, lost leads after hours, struggle to reply to reviews, things like that. So notice that those two do have a red required. All these other ones, as far as brand promise, brand value, you can look at the video. I go over all of it and so forth and go over this setup here inside of that particular video. Again, I'll link it to the video here below. So that's Brand Voice. Now, with that, this is why it's, if you're looking at, let me blow this back out. If you're coming here about Ask AI, this is where it's important to select that brand voice at the very beginning, because if you don't, then the writing may be off compared to if you're using it in other places. But it's nice that now Highlevel seems to be connecting brand voice with all the new AI feature updates. That's just what I'm seeing. I don't know that for any fact, but Conversation AI was redone. It's included. Ask AI has been redone, and now it's including brand voice. And it just seems like that's going to be standard, that you can connect a brand voice to it. Now, unfortunately, with Conversation AI, it does force you to choose one. You have to create one with Conversation AI. Here, you don't even have to use one with Ask AI either, if you don't want to. If you don't have one configured, it's not like AI is not going to work. It just won't have the background information inside of the brand voice information to understand your business and who you're trying to target. So the writing may be off a little bit. Having said that, that's just some background information I want to give you regarding Ask AI and some of the other pieces and components that it integrates with. Now, let me show you a few things that I've done with Ask AI. Now, here are one of the things that I've experienced with just my I guess, small amount of testing and limited use of the Ask AI system. It can take, if you're doing images with this, it can take a couple of minutes for the images to render, which, you know, is pretty typical with ChatGPT if you're giving it a prompt. But some of the other text-generated stuff happens pretty quickly. Now, one of the nice things about this is that you can sit back and, if you're familiar with ChatGPT and how to go through and update an existing project, and maybe you're working on a project and you want it to change or modify something, you can keep adding, changing, modifying to that particular same project, if you will. But if you want to create a new one, now you have to go create a new project. It's something very similar to that is how they have built Ask AI. So if we click up in here in this top, I'm going to try to blow this up a little bit here. So again, this is create a new chat. Now, if you click on this, you can look at chat history, okay? So this right here is some of the past prompting that you've done, and it also includes the information that you've included with that. So if you've generated images, the images will be there for you to go back and look at later and things like that. So this is a nice feature. So if you click on chat history, and I'm just going to show you, I was just playing with it today, and there were some other ones here that I was trying to look for, but it is buggy. So right now, sometimes I've noticed that Ask AI, if I have a generated image, sometimes it says I can't generate an image. Other times it will generate an image. So let me see what this one was. So if I come here, I'm just trying to sit back and get in here to look at this whole. Okay, so I just had it come in here and just say, print an image of a koala bear wearing a t-shirt that says use Highlevel. So again, that's what I got. It was a very basic prompt. But again, this is nice because if you ever want to start using this, I was actually looking at possibly considering using this as a image creation tool for being able to do additional social media posts. So if you want to do a post, or if you want to sit back and add an image to an existing social media post, you know, this would be a great way to sit back, test it. And you can sit back and just say, no, I don't like the koala bear, make the koala bear smile, stuff like that. I didn't do it with this one here, but I'm sure you could do that. So here I'm going to come back to chat history and look at building a sales funnel. So this right here is where I was trying to sit back and have it build a funnel. But again, I don't know if this is buggy, like it didn't do it or not. There's a link right on the main page where it says create a funnel. But for right now, it just wasn't creating a funnel. I'm not quite sure why. So right now I did want to sit back and say, create a Facebook post that will, this is, just goes back to some of the features, create a Facebook post that will help sell AI employee feature to small business owners. Now you could do this right here inside of the content AI system inside of Social Planner, but it's cool that you can do it right here too. And actually sit back and schedule this. So here's the post, and then moving forward here, it says, let me know of any changes. I said, forgive me, the scrolling is not working that great. Creating an image to use in this post. Now, again, I just wanted to sit back and write the smallest prompt that I possibly can. If I've already created a post, the post already has information. ChatGPT should be able to read the post and say, okay, let me create an image based upon this and see what I get. But then it's, I'm sorry, but I can't create images or graphics. So this is where it gets a little bit buggy, where sometimes it creates images and other times it doesn't, and I don't really know why. Now, if you're like me, one of the things I ask right off the bat when I'm using this is, what is the cost? Now, this is one of the ones that I could not figure out. I'm sorry. I called and asked support and tried to find out right now, is there a, for using this Ask AI, you're using content AI, you're using image creation, you're using all these other things. Is there a cost of this? Are you going to be implementing, is it going to be a cost to content AI? Is it going to be a cost to whatever? I didn't get an answer right now. So I don't really know if there's going to be a cost to this. If you're not using the unlimited AI employee feature, if you are, you don't need to worry about it. It's all included. But if you're not, then are you going to be charged if you're just sitting back and playing, or if you're creating an image, are you being charged nickel an image or whatever it is? And next thing you start playing around and generate 500 images, and now you've got a nice ever bill every month. I don't know. So that's unfortunately something that I tried to find out and I just could not find out. So some of the other things I wanted to do is I was just trying to create more of image, and it still wouldn't create it. This was on the particular day. Now I was saying, create me a funnel for the purpose of selling AI employee services to business owners. The funnel should explain all the benefits the owner gets with the service, as well as having an opt-in form to be contacted regarding the service. Now, this is the kind of prompt where I'm hoping Ask AI is going. So you can see here, you don't even need to even create a funnel. You don't have to create, you don't have to create the funnel. You just ask it, create a funnel. Give me all the benefits. If this is built into Highlevel, it should have access to all the Highlevel help articles. So I shouldn't have to tell it the AI employee services. It should already know or be able to utilize the help services and the help document to scan that, see all the feature sets, and then build content based upon that through in the funnel. And then also give me an opt-in form for this. So again, if there's not an opt-in form, then then at ChatGPT should be able to create the form inside of Highlevel and then integrate it to the funnel and do all of it for you. So that is what I was hoping for, but this is what I got. I just got basically a text-based version of this is what you need. Here's how you need to build a funnel. Forgive me, the scrolling is not working here. Step one, do this. Step two, step three. Here's all the feature sets and things like that. Here's the opt-in form. I'm not sure where this thing is actually at or not, if this is just an image. But you see the point. It built the funnel for you, but it built it in text form. And now you have to copy paste it and build the components, which again defeats the purpose. If you're using Ask AI to do it, it should build the funnel for you, or it should build multiple funnels for you. If you want to build me a funnel for, you know, the electrical services, the home services, the roofing services, the solar services, all of these things, selling AI services specifically using the challenges that these people have in their businesses or something like that. So you should be able to sit back and create all this stuff for you. And then it just saves you time. You don't have to sit back and build it. The funnel AI feature can build the funnel automatically. If it needs anything else, it'll ask you, what tone do you want the writing in? Well, if you don't already have a brand voice, and it should ask you. If not, it should use the tone built into your brand voice. So it is pretty cool about this new feature that about Ask AI and how it's integrating with this. But let me see if there's something else here. I was doing this one time, generating an image of a puppy with a t-shirt that says, you can do it. And I'm just thinking, of course, everybody just loves a cute puppy smiling or a kitten or something like that. I don't know if you're doing social posts, maybe you do inspirational posts, motivational posts and things like that for it, just to let your subscribers know, maybe first thing in the morning. I know I used to run a campaign that was like inspirational. I'd give them a message right at 7 o'clock in the morning. So whenever they looked, they'd sit back and say, you can do it. A crush today, carpe diem, something like that. You get them to want to look at my social media posts just so that they can get an inspirational message for the day. Again, this is why people attempt at it, but it is a cute little puppy, but just, you can do it on it. So you see, and then likewise, I think the one I did today was not that great. The image right here definitely could be better. Generating an image of a small business owner smiling with his right hand held out and thumbs up. And I just give him hey, way to go. Yes. And a t-shirt that says, I hired an AI employee. So here, if we take a look at this, notice it's close, but what do you see? The hand is in the way of the employee. So the word employee. So I hired an employee, or just without the E. That was just funny. And I'm sure I could sit back and keep playing with it, but these are just some of the cool things that that Ask AI is already able to do. If you haven't played with it, I would seriously say, go play with it. Check it out. It's definitely going to be here. It's a part of the AI employee platform. And if you bought the AI employee, or you're going through the summer of AI right now, and you have the free AI employee for 30 days, use it. Come in here and look at this thing. It is great. See what its capabilities are. I did not have it go through and build a community here. I didn't want to go through and have a community that I couldn't like remove or delete. So I didn't really do that. But anyway, I hope you learned a few things. I hope this is informational for you. If it was, hit the like button. Leave me a comment if you have any questions regarding this. And guys, thanks so much for hanging in there with me. If you have not subscribed to my channel, smash the subscribe button. Hit that bell notification, because right now I publish a couple times a week, and I publish on many different topics for Highlevel. Hopefully one of them will be of interest to you, like this one right here, Ask AI. Have a great day. Bye-bye.